That's some pure aggression right there. Yo, it's 2:36 p.m. on a Saturday, Sabado, for all my Espanol-speaking peoples. Christina made, homemade from scratch, pumpkin cream cheese bread. Last night when I came home and it was room temperature, I liked it. Christina wasn't crazy about it. Today, that it's really cold from the refrigerator, I love it. Christina's like, at least it's moist. But she just wants more cinnamon and sugar and stuff in it. It's not super sweet. I love it. And I have already had one piece. I know what you're thinking. Trooper, why is that slice so small? You're a growing boy. I know. But this is my second one. That's why. Made it on down to the strip on a Saturday. A little later than I wanted it to be. Isn't that the case every day? Hasn't that been the case almost every single day for like 4 years, maybe longer? It's 3:41. I had iced coffee, so I have a bladder situation. Time for a little, what should we call it, lunch? We'll call the pumpkin bread breakfast, and we'll call this lunch. Committed to my pledge of more pizza in 2021. Not real hair. I wanted a cheese, but they only had sausage or spinach. It wasn't super fresh and hot, but it was still pretty damn good. What is this, some kind of new art installation in front of the fountains? I get it. That is very Las Vegas 2020, even though it's 2021. But no. All right, so I gotta figure out where to play the poker today, but I have a phone meeting with a guy about a thing in about 10 minutes. So I'm going back to the Trooper Mobile because it's just easier that way. I know what you wanna know. Trooper, what's the weather like? It's a cool 54 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 mile per hour winds, make you go like this. Even if you don't have a cold or a sniffles, you just go like that. Make you want a cup of soup. Not a bowl of soup, a cup of soup. Make you want to walk around with a cup of soup, sipping it and doing that. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Look at these dummies. I mean, the sidewalk is right here. It's right here.
Why do you walk? Okay, all right. Walk through the bushes now. I mean, if I had little kids with me, I would stay on the sidewalk. That's just me though. I have had mixed emotions in the past about photo bombers in the vlog. First of all, that one lady got us pretty good the other day when I was at the Fremont. But you know, it could be funny to just let people photobomb the vlog, but it's more fun for me to ruin their day by doing this.
Hey, vlog. You doing the vlog?
As soon as I say it, four dudes in like tuxedos decide they're gonna photobomb. And it's like I'm psychic almost. I know they're gonna do it. But some people, you really know they're gonna do it before they do it. And so these five little dudes, I don't know if they were kids, I mean, whatever they were, what prompted this whole rant right now, I wouldn't call it a rant because it's not angry or anything, but it is a, what is it, a diatribe? Definition of diatribe. Forceful and bitter verbal, no, it's not a diatribe. All right, speech about photobombing, the whole thing that prompted it, were these like five? Those two wanted to do it. I'm too good at ruining it, like pissing on their photobombing parade. For me, it's fun to piss on the photobombing parade. I don't know why. I get like this little satisfaction of knowing that even though I'm looking over here, I can tell when two people over here are getting ready to photobomb and I just hit them with this.
Are you a YouTuber?
Yeah.
Yeah, bro.
Oh, Lord. I don't know what that drunk ass dude was saying, but where am I going? The car is this way. I was just walking and rambling about photobombing, and yeah, it would be funny, but I get this like little inner satisfaction out of just like slow rolling people who think they're gonna photobomb. I've been caught a couple of times, but I've literally slow rolled hundreds if not thousands of potential photobombers. That guy just photobombed the back of the camera. Another one of those. Nothing makes me feel smarter than when random strangers are going like facing the back of the camera. I'm never gonna get over it. I need some sort of small hidden camera facing that direction so that you guys can see people photobomb the back of the camera because it's hilarious. By the way, there's a reasonable chance it might start raining, and they're still saying snow on Monday. Gamble meeting over, and it got dark outside. Like, it was daylight and now it's dark. What the heck? It's colder too, by the way. We'll be right back.
Wow. Just when you thought you've seen it all, something happened tonight that was definitely a new one. I made a pretty terrible mistake, but the reason I made the mistake was because of the mass, the plexiglass, and the friggin' loud-ass music at Planet Hollywood. First of all, on my first buy-in, in a straddle pot, I got in with 10s against Ace King and lost. The same guy, he actually moved over one seat to my left, and he knew the vlogs. So I'm in the game for 400 at this point, and I have about, I don't know, 175, 180, I think, to start this hand. And I had, this was a button straddle. I was in the hijack. Dude was in the cutoff on my left. Folds around to me, I've got two jacks. I make it 30. By the way, the button straddle is $10. I make it 30. Cutoff calls on my left. Button calls. 93 in the middle. The flop was king high. I want to say something like king 7-3. I led for 30 with the intentions of probably going all the way with this hand. Based on the way the cutoff and the button were playing, they were, you know, splashing around. They were doing all the straddling. I led for 30. But I led for 30 on purpose, because I wanted to look weak. Even though I am weaker than a king, I'm stronger than, so I lead out for 30. Cutoff calls, button folds. The turn is, I don't even know. I think it was a deuce actually. I move all in for, I guess about 110, something in that range. And this is where it gets weird. If you've ever played at Planet Hollywood Poker Room, you know the music is loud. It's loud. But on a Saturday night at 11 p.m.-ish, 10, 11 p.m., 10 p.m., it's super loud. It's like a friggin' nightclub in there. So under normal conditions with no masks and no plexiglass, it is loud. But without the mask and the plexiglass, you would be able to hear. So the guy in the cutoff said the word fold. I heard him say, I fold. I heard him say both of those words, I fold. I was gonna show him the hand because he watches the vlog, and the thing is he was trying to say more than just I fold. When I heard I fold, I immediately put my head like this to go like forward of the plexiglass a little bit, and I said, what was that? I said, what? And he said, I fold. And I showed him my two jacks. And I don't know why, but for some reason, as soon as I showed him the jacks, I was like, I felt it. There was more to the story. He was trying to say, if I fold and give the dealer $5, will you show? That's what he was trying to say. Well, he has King Jack in his hand, and now we're in a weird situation where, yes, it's loud. Yes, I heard him say, I fold. No, I'm not sure that his intention was to fold. His intention, from what I gather, was to ask me a question. And I was just like, well, it's too late now. What am I gonna do? He said, I have a king. And I was like, I mean, what am I supposed to do? You know, what am I? And then he has to call, because any poker player who sees your hand, you show them the hand, they're gonna then act on the hand. He hasn't completed an action yet. So I don't blame him for doing that, but I just wonder what would have happened had I called the floor and said that I heard I fold twice. You know, I don't even know if the dealer heard it. So I don't know what would have happened. I was trying to be friendly by showing the jacks, and for no real good reason, except just generally the way the game was going. I don't know. I mean, I guess he could have had a weak king, which is what he had. He had King Jack. So it was just a really stupid mistake. And I'm pissed at myself still. After that hand, I'm down 400. He was playing a tournament on WSOP.com at the time, and he said if he made a certain position, he wanted to give me 100 of it back. Well, he tried to give me 100 back right off the bat. He was like, I feel bad. And I was like, no, I refuse the 100. I don't want the 100 back. It was my stupid mistake, and I should never be friendly and show hands at the table, whether you watch the vlog or not, and I should never not call the floor if I think that I have a case. Because ultimately the floor would make the decision, you know, or whatever. So, but I didn't want to be a dick and I wanted to be friendly. So I was like, no, I refuse the 100. But as he was leaving, he insisted on me taking 100 back, and I took it. Because, like, I don't know, what am I gonna do? I don't know morally. Like, morally, I'm not even talking about the rules. Like, morally speaking, the actual what's right and what's wrong, what happens there? You know, there's a 93 in the pot before the flop. There's 153 in the pot after the flop. And then my bet on the river, I mean, my bet on the turn was like 111 or 116. I don't remember the exact amount. So, morally, what happens? I think that morally, it's my mistake. Clearly, I'm never showing jacks before the action is complete with a king on the board, with the guy calling the flop. But ultimately, it's my mistake, and it's a really stupid mistake. Wait until the cards are in the muck. Wait until they're pitched forward, face down towards the dealer. Don't ever, 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 ever do what I did tonight. It was a horrible, horrible thing to have done. I lose 323 for the night. I did reload and continue to play, but it's like one in the morning at this point, and I'm over it. How do I do that? How do I do that? I mean, I'm sure that some of you will remember Phil Ivey mucking a flush in a tournament that I'm sure cost a lot of money to enter. Probably no money to him, but the point is, I guess it's possible for anyone to make this type of error. So remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, leave a comment down below. Ha! Shit! Showed my hand! I'll see you next time. We'll be right back.